Back here again.
Yep. I got it. Yep. Yep.
Still gonna make me take off the shirt. JK, you ain't seeing shit till I compete.
I'm with my boy Keone Pearson, and yo, shit's about to go down, man. Yeah, I'm just ready to fuck shit up, man. Ready to get huge. And my friend here, he's ready to just fuck shit up in a different way. I'm allowed to swear, right?
Yeah, I mean, everything I have today, it wasn't given to me. I mean, I had five jobs to be able to live the life that I do now. So I busted my ass to live this life and being able to travel and bodybuild. And so I'm grateful for that.
I really think that I'm going to be the one to take out Chris Bumstead. So I just feel like one more big off season, and that's going to be it.
Oh, you said it with such conviction. I was like, what's going on?
I ain't taking shit off. Don't you be fucking...
Back here again. Last time you saw him, it was like 13 weeks out. I was training with Ray. Now we got the Canadians over here coming to get this work in the Texas heat. Well, cold. But we're just under 6 weeks out from the Olympia. And now we're just digging deep. So they're gonna give me an extra push today. I'm gonna push them. You already know, I don't talk much. I just train. And yeah, let's go.
I'll do like a probably dumbbell press. Yeah. And then I'll do a Smith machine press, flat or incline. I'll do incline, dumbbells, flat, Smith. Yeah. Another fly, another press, and yeah. Simple shit, it ain't much to do on the
the same height.
People think we're twins. We got the same clothes, got the beard. Found my older brother in Canada. Five more, come on.
Started off season probably 4 weeks in, so we're just gonna take things slow and see how the off season goes. I'm not rushing towards any shows. I'm gonna pay attention to the body, and when I feel I've made the necessary improvements, we'll see what kind of shows are available and go from there.
Yeah, we're gonna do like a flat press, and then we'll do an incline, and another fly, go from there. Try to hit the chest in all different angles, upper, lower. Just keep going. Just trying to carve it out at this point. How heavy did you go on Smith? How heavy did you go on Smith?
Flat or Smith and, I don't know, so they're probably not that heavy.
So you haven't gone that heavy, really?
I'm 3 weeks into off season. I'm a guy, I'm big on just being able to stimulate the muscle, you know? I like lifting heavy, but only if I can stimulate properly, you know? So I've lifted pretty heavy weights before. I mean, I still lift relatively heavy, but for me, it's all about how I connect with the muscle, how I can contract, because how I use it is everything, right? You can throw up 200 pound dumbbells and get 8 reps, but you're not feeling that in your chest. What the fuck is the point, you know? So yeah, I'm just, my training's the same whether I'm on prep or off season, pretty much. It's always about the quality.
Huh?
Yeah, just some heads out too.
That just feel like a long thing almost.
Sure.
It feel heavy. Are we gonna make it look right today?
Hey! Hey, one more!
Come on. So the people that have trained me recently and the training styles that I kind of have adopted have been Big Mike Van Wicks and Chris Cormier's. And also, you know, I like to go heavy here and there. So when I go heavy, what I do is I work up with like very low volume. You know, I might do like a couple warm-up sets, like 4 or 5 reps. And I keep doing these warm-up sets and I get to like 2 heavy working sets. So this was like a lot more volume than I'm used to, as well as a heavy weight. So I feel like stuff like this, first of all, the intensity's gotta be there. Volume, I feel like volume's always gotta be there. So both those things were there. We're all able to push each other, get some force reps. I'm big on force reps. Doesn't matter how hard you train, what kind of pedigree you got. If you don't have someone there, you can't get force reps. And if you can't get force reps, somebody's able to do more than you somewhere else. So, you know, your competitors, they got training partners. If you don't got training partners, you're not gonna get better, so.
Yep, I got it. Yep.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on.
One more. Drop it.
45. Come on.
It was good, man. Plus, I needed that push and that extra, you know, the extra motivation to keep driving. You know, when I have workouts like this, for me, I just got 1% better. So that's kind of how I look at it. So now I can go home and smile and not be pissed off because I had a good workout. So now I got to keep this momentum and, you know, have that same, you know, hype like I had today for the rest of the week. So that's kind of how I think about this workout.
I normally did, it's like a good technique to kind of take them out of the equation. Just kind of limit the range of motion. And also, whenever you shorten the range of motion, there's more tension within that shortened period. So you're activating the chest more, and you get more chest. You're gonna fuck the chest up even more. So a little trick that I do. I don't go like ass to grass, so to speak, touching the chest.
One day.
I don't let the low energy stuff faze me. I'm just different when it comes to that. Like, the more tired I am, the harder I push. You know, I mean, the way I train today, that's how I'm gonna train if it's zero carbs. So it don't fucking matter. It's just how I do it. That's just my mindset, you know. When people come here and mope around because they're tired and hungry and drained, that's their problem, you know. They're already thinking in their head, I'm tired, it's gonna be a hard workout. When you think like that, it's going to be a hard workout. So Patrick always tell me, when you manifest that, it's gonna happen. So if you manifest a good workout before you come in here, it's gonna be a good workout, no matter how you feel.
Come on, all the way. Let's go. For me, like, this workout is led by Keon, so we'll do whatever he's doing. For my workouts, I usually do three, four presses, 2 to 3 flashes, depends on how I'm feeling. For me, it's a lot of volume. I do a lot of volume. I'm a short rest period guy, so this is a little different, but it's good. It's good. The intensity is definitely there, and feeling good, man. Feel like I got a good pump. And yeah, we're just gonna keep pushing. We might have one more after this fly, but ultimately, I'm not sure. It's up to Keon, but we're gonna find out. God. God.
Yeah.
No, it's just, it's cool to actually, you know, be here and train with them, because you can see how someone trains online. You see that the intensity is there, but there's nothing like actually training with somebody and like getting a feel for everything. And yeah, I'm excited for him because I see he's got a pedigree. I see he's a hard worker. I know he knows how to dig deep. So and he's got tons of potential. So I really want to see him do well at the Olympia. And you know, as he said, like, the mindset, that's everything. You know, you just come in, you just focus on fucking shit up. And I believe he will. So I'm excited for this year's old.